This is Dr. Sheenam Bansal. So today we will talk about dynamic stability of the glenohumeral joint. The glenohumeral joint, that is shoulder joint, is very unstable as there is less glenoid area and more humeral head. And depth of the socket is also very less. So it is very unstable as compared to hip joint. The critical stage of dynamic stability of the glenohumeral joint is easily appreciated if we see an axial skiagram of the joint in 120 degree of abduction. Now you can see here the axial view. This is an axial view of the glenohumeral joint in 120 degree abduction. What we can see here, all the humeral head is in front, is anteriorly. A small part is in contact with the glenoid. So you can think how unstable it is actually. Next is the, we can erase this. Okay. So now see glenohumeral index. What is glenohumeral index? We have glenohumeral index vertical type. We have transverse type. The transverse glenohumeral index provides horizontal stability. Transverse glenohumeral index, we take the transverse diameter of glenoid divided by transverse diameter of the humerus humeral head into 100. So that's how we calculate the glenohumeral index. Transverse glenohumeral index provides horizontal stability. In primates, everything is favoring the more stability of the shoulder joint. That is more depth of the socket, more transverse glenohumeral index, more retro tilt of the glenoid. Everything is favoring the stability. Next, we have the in the picture, Dr. A.K. Saha has shown that how glenohumeral index is measured. How we take the transverse diameter of the glenoid and humerus likewise. So this picture is about rolling of humeral head in the glenoid. See, every muscle is providing the stability. Is trying to rotator cuff is actually trying to provide the stability. So we have the subscapularis. We know subscapularis is the anterior muscle. It is an anterior stabilizer. Infraspinatus and teres minor is the posterior stabilizer, and supraspinatus is vertical stabilizer. Then so these muscles are providing the stability. Then we have in this picture, he has shown that when we do in the horizontal axis, you can see when we do a particular elevation, what happens? Firstly, we know action potential. Y axis action potential is shown. Action potential rises when we start doing abduction in a supraspinatus muscle. We can see infraspinatus muscles, subscapularis muscle. But when we do 150 to 180 degree abduction, you can see subscapularis action potential is declining. I will mark here. We can see action potential in the subscapularis is declining in the 150 to 180 degree abduction, but in the infraspinatus it is rising as earlier. Okay, so this was the difference in the infraspinatus muscle and subscapularis muscle shown by him. Then that's the same thing I have written here. In abduction, the power of the subscapularis and infraspinatus progressively rises to stabilize the head during abduction from 60 to 150 degree. Thereafter, power of subscapularis shows a rapid decline. Okay, now we can see next picture. Yeah. Now in the picture number fifth written here, in the picture five, this is the back of the primates. It is showing the large size of the scapula. You can see here the large size of the scapula is for more muscle bulk. Obviously, it will provide more surface area for the muscle larger. And it is a scapula of human beings that is of less size, so muscle bulk will be less. Now in this picture, we can see the scapular muscles. Scapular muscles is written here. We can see trapezius, serratus interior, metascapula. These muscles, scapular muscles are used in the flail shoulder, like we have flail shoulder in the polio. So we can see trapezius, serratus anterior action potential rises within the abduction and flexion. But you can see peak of the action potential comes earlier while doing flexion than abduction. So this was the difference shown by him. Next picture, now here he has shown how humerus osteotomy, is helpful for the for decreasing the retroversion. See, everything is favoring the stability in the shoulder joint. So we have there, we know retro tilt of the glenoid is will provide more stability in cases in the primate. It will provide more stability. If now we know is everything is favoring the stability in the primates. So retro tilt is also, or retro tilt of the glenoid is also more in the primates. Here, bird's eye view of the human scapula is there. Then we have axial skiagram showing the retro tilt. Retro tilt is favorable for the stability, but anterior tilt of the glenoid is not favorable. It will lead to dislocation. In some proportion, we have got the anterior tilt. And we can see in the cases of interior dislocation, in the cases of anterior tilt, people will have more anterior dislocation. Here we have he has shown that how we can increase the retro tilt of the glenoid, by doing osteotomy.